I'm here at the Ten Goose Boxing Gym, standing here, Ricky Funes, former fighter, current trainer. Ricky, every trainer has their secrets. Some trainers say, Ellie, if you come to my gym, you're always invited, but keep your camera at home. No, I'm serious. They like me, but they're just like, they don't want to give away
their secrets.
Exactly. You're going to share today one of your secrets that you do in training that I've been to other gyms and people have quoted this to me and told me, I take this from the Goosen gym. So
really?
Yes. I was in East LA in one of like the most roughest areas, and the trainer over there was like, yeah, let me tell you. Because I asked him, what do you pick up from other trainers? So today, what are you going to show us? You're going to teach us how to use the right hand, but instead of using the gloves, boxing gloves, not MMA gloves, you're going to use?
Gardening gloves.
Gardening, 99 cents store in the house right here,
exactly.
Gardening gloves.
This is a...
You're going to... You have weeds in the gym.
No, hey, listen, these are what my nephew uses. People say, man, those
Soto Carras too?
Soto Carras, Corrales used to use these. Bertel, he's when been working out here lately. So he's been using some of these, just a new technique for him.
Do you cut off the fingers or do they come back?
I cut off the tips. People say, hey, why you use gardening gloves? You know, they will injure their hands. You gotta understand this. When you go into a professional fight, you allow so much padding into your hand wrapping. And remember, you got padding also on the gloves. So there's a lot of fighters that I have worked with in the past. James Toney, remember this. James Toney, and I've seen a lot of fighters like Mayweather. When they're training, they use a lot of padding on their hand wrapping. And not only that, remember there's a big padding already before on their hand wrapping. And then when they put on those gloves that they have, big padding also. They use 10 ounces, 14 ounces to hit the heavy bag.
16s,
even to hit the heavy bag. Why? It's conditioning, yeah, but you know what? You're not strengthening your knuckles. You want your hands to be solid rock. Because remember, when you go into the professional fight, you got a thin padding on the wrapping, and you got 8 ounces or 10 ounces, which is not a lot of padding. And once you hit that guy on the head,
you could hurt yourself.
You could hurt yourself.
You
could break your hand. A lot of fighters have broken their hand. Diego Corrales, when he fought Justin Jucco, both of his hands got broken. Why? Because he was doing his training, he had big padding. James Toney would injure his hands. Mayweather would injure his hands. You know what I mean?
Robert Garcia told me sometimes they used to use maxi pads.
Yeah. They come all with kinds of stuff.
Okay.
We use toilet paper.
Okay.
As you saw me, there's a video that you did with me a while back with Fernando Guerrero. I use toilet paper, something that I learned from Joe Goosen, who's my mentor and my teacher.
Okay.
This is where I learned this from. You know, once you start training your hands with these kind of small gloves, your hands become solid rock. And I'm going to show you
But how. Any risk in training with that? Only the first week?
First week you'd be really sore because of the muscles that your hands never are not used to.
Okay.
You know
and
I mean?
From there on?
And from there on?
You each start knuckle getting, of Soto Carras looked like a quarter.
Well, yeah, exactly. Not only that, your hands starts, you know, building calluses in
like
your knuckles.
Like marbles.
Like, hey, Ellie, let me tell you this. This becomes like a really dangerous. Okay, let me show you how to throw the right hand from here, Ellie.
Okay.
This is what we use, Ellie. Boxing, when you stand in your boxing, if you're right, I'm right-handed. So I stand in my boxing position, Ellie.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, my right hand comes to my chin, from my chin. A lot of fighters get the right hand and they pull and then they throw the right hand wide. They try to build more power. We train our fighters, make sure that they throw the right hand straight from the chin and use their shoulders more. When they throw the right hand.
Now I notice you're stepping into your punch.
Exactly, you bring your whole butt in and you snap your power, you strength that right hand. You stretch it out.
So here's my question. When people are watching this at home and they said, hey, I could get these gardening gloves, they're not too expensive. They're not like some high-end boxing gloves, $200-$400. How often should they wear them? And when do you mix in the padding and the gloves?
Well, I have my nephew sometimes use these for three weeks straight. Then I change it up to the regular boxing fight. Since he's fighting March 2nd, God willing, he'll be making his pro debut, has been being postponed. I switch it up and down. It all depends. You know
but,
what I mean?
But you're not gonna spar with that, obviously.
No, of course. Come on, Ellie. You'll kill somebody with these.
So you spar normally, you wrap the hands normally, yeah. But when you just do like the Monday.
When we do the floor work.
When you do the different bags.
When we do different bags, we use the. Not only that, we use these also to make sure that we turn the knuckles. Every time we throw a punch, I make sure that they see.
So MMA fighters could come train here too, huh?
Oh yeah, I have a few MMA fighters that come here and work out. They use those small gloves.
Yeah.
Mainly Ellie, sorry, you gotta edit that. Ellie, I call you Effie because of my boy Effie. He's just shalom, shalom.
All Jews look alike.
Ellie, so yeah, we use these just to make sure that we turn those knuckles.
Uh-huh.
You know, and we make those hands strong like a rock.
There you have it, Ricky. Thanks so much for sharing this today. We're gonna try it. I've seen fighters use them, and their hands definitely do look like two sledgehammers. They don't look like hands. And that's the secret right there. The secret of the gardening gloves at the Goosen Gym. Stay tuned.
Well, it's not a secret, but, you know, it's out there. You got to remember this. Back in the 1900s, they didn't have big padding gloves. They would use bag gloves.
You know what you need to do, Ricky?
Huh?
Is go to some gardening company and market the 10 Goose gardening / boxing training gloves. And start marketing.
You just give me a great idea.
All right, do it.
I think make sure that I do the right thing with the
bags. Go. About to punch a hole in the bag.
I feel like making a comeback.